We've got yet another Samsung A series phone with us today. The Galaxy A21s is Samsung's newest offline focused phone. In today's video, let's unbox and spend some hands-on time with this A21s. Hey guys, Ash here from C4A Tech, and if you do end up liking what you see here, please subscribe and turn on notifications by hitting that bell icon. Let's now get started. The A21s is a pretty familiar device, and that familiarity starts right from the box. The on-box graphic, the logos, I can't help but have a sense of deja vu here. It's a pretty standard Samsung affair. Let's now cut the seal. Opening up the box, we have an insert here with a SIM ejector tool, the regular warranty card, region lock and quick start guides, and finally, the Galaxy A21s. Removing it from its protective plastic cover, peeling the sticker off the back. This back, it's still plastic, it's got that rainbowy hue going for it. Now, let's get back to it in a second. Next, we have a 15-watt charger and a USB Type-C cable, and that's pretty much it for the inbox contents. Let's now get to the A21s. The weird thing here is that Samsung seems to have skipped out on the A21 and jumped straight to the A21s from the A20s. Why? Your guess is as good as mine. Now, the major changes with this phone from the A20s, it's got to be what's on the inside. Instead of the 14-nanometer Snapdragon 450 chip, we now get an 8-nanometer Exynos 850. The base RAM storage is now 464, still eMMC though. Okay, so what's this Exynos 850? Where does it fall on the SoC pecking order? Not far from the Snapdragon 450 in terms of performance. So it should be quite okay for day-to-day tasks since the performance, like I said, is expected to be similar, but the fact that it's manufactured on the 8-nanometer process means the Exynos 850 should be far more power efficient. The battery life on the A20s was pretty good, and that was with the 14-nanometer Snapdragon 450 and a 4000 mAh battery. But here, not only do we have an 8-nanometer chip, but also a 25% higher capacity battery, 5000 mAh, so I'm expecting the battery life to be excellent. Despite that mammoth battery, like other A-series phones, the A21s also manages to keep its weight below 200 grams. The overall footprint is similar to that of its predecessor. In fact, the A21s is a tad narrower because of a minor aspect ratio change from 19.5:9 to 20:9. The screen-to-body ratio though has gone up since we now get a punch hole instead of a notch, and inside this punch hole sits a 13-megapixel camera. The selfies that it took, they seemed pretty detailed. I like the colors here, the skin tones appear natural, and of course, there's a live focus mode included too, so you could boost up the bokeh of your background. Coming back to the display, I was really hoping for a Full HD panel this time, but sadly, that's not the case. The resolution remains unchanged from the last gen, HD+, but this seems like a bright LCD panel. The colors on this Infinity O seem decent. At 6.5 inches, the screen dominates the front and is quite reminiscent of the A20s. It's not just the display, but also the build overall. The A21s feels quite easily wieldable since the display is covered by 2.5D glass. Samsung does not mention what they are using for protection, but there's an oleophobic coating, and this 2.5D glass coupled with the curves to the edges on the back make the A21s feel slimmer than it actually is. Grip still remains an issue though due to the slippery nature of glossy plastic. Other placements include the power and volume keys to the right, which feel nice and clicky. We have the secondary noise cancelling microphone up top, a triple card tray to the left, and to the bottom we have the 3.5mm headphone jack, a USB Type-C port, and the internal speaker along with the primary microphone. The camera array is boxy, that's Samsung's 2020 design, and the fingerprint scanner is below this camera array. It doesn't feel like the fastest, but it does seem to get the job done. Face unlock is present, and that felt really quick. On the software side of things, we get One UI 2.1 based on Android 10. Despite this not being an AMOLED panel, the dark mode manages to look nice. There are a lot of customization options like themes, and there is support for FM radio. Now, another one of the major changes that we get with the A21s is its optics. We get an extra sensor, so four rear cameras this time. The primary is a 48-megapixel sensor with an f2.0 lens. Under bright light, this camera manages to capture some good-looking shots with vibrant colors and good detail. The dynamic range is pretty good, with the A21s seeming to retain quite a bit of detail from the shadow. There is no dedicated night mode though. Moving over to the other three sensors, we get an 8-megapixel ultra-wide, which seems to do a nice enough job. Then there's a 2-megapixel depth sensor for live focus shots like these. And lastly, we get another 2-megapixel sensor, this time for macros, to get close-up shots like the ones you're seeing on screen now. So what do you think about these samples? Do you feel cameras are a strong point here? Leave a comment down below. Okay, let's now talk price. The A21s comes in at 17,000 rupees for the 464 variant. And given what Samsung offers, the price does seem a little steep. Now, admittedly, the A series is pretty focused on offline sales. And maybe given the other offline competition in the segment, the A21s could be a competent offering. So what do you think? Let me know in the comments below. And with that, we get to the end of this video. If you do end up liking it, please subscribe, turn on notifications by hitting that bell icon if you haven't yet. And thanks a lot for watching. Till next time, my name's Ash. You've been watching C4 Retech, and I'm signing off for now. You guys have a great day. Bye-bye.